The beta is out and you can go use it. I've created the world's first post-quantum VPN. It has post-quantum cryptographic algorithms that can literally protect you from quantum computers. That's going to be trouble in the next few years. So if you want to come use it, come download it. It's in the description, calvipn.com. The beta is out. This has post-quantum cryptography, which is basically just hard math problems, and you can use it. And this will save you from getting retroactively hacked, because hackers can actually steal VPN encrypted data right now. And then in the future, if they have one of these devices, they can decrypt your data that they stole. But anyway, let's get back to the video. All right.
Have you ever heard of the most complex subject in the known universe? One which is still far from being understood, one which is the literal cause of everything, one which made high school students hate school, and most importantly, one that made Rick and Morty possible. By the name of the video, you probably know what I'm talking about. Gender studies. Seriously now, I mean, penguinologism. Now for real, today we're going to speak about...
Is that a real thing? Penguinologist? Does he know as much as I know about the physics of penguin poo?
Whoa, 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 whoa.
About chicken nugget science. Fine, I'll just stop.
Well, whilst you stopped, you should come sign up for my free VPN, which is a brand new type of VPN. And it can literally protect you from quantum computers. And there's 11 servers. They're very fast, very fast. You can use it for free. Come get it. And we're going to use all the money to colonize Venus. So if you want to see me terraforming Venus, you should come sign up to this. You get a free month. Anyway.
The first branch of physics is the most boring one and the only one that you can observe.
You know, look, just to jokes aside for a second, classical mechanics is very, very important. And advanced classical mechanics is very, very important to understand quantum physics when you get to the, you know, deeper areas of like quantum field theory. You gotta do the classical stuff, even though it is really, really boring.
By yourself. It says that objects will move if you kick them, and that if you punch somebody, they will punch you back with the same force. No matter how ugly you are, you still attract the entire universe towards yourself with a force inversely proportional to the distance. Next, we have electro.
But because of something called dark energy, you know, this doesn't actually work out. Gravity is actually a very weak force. And, you know, on cosmic scales, things actually have to be rather close for this to happen. It's counterintuitive. But the universe is actually expanding and it's increasing in speed. And that's because of something we just say, dark energy. We don't know what it is. Don't know if it's real. Dark energy is our solution. Gravity. Yeah, there's problems. There's problems, guys. It's all right. We're working on it. We're working on them. And we'll get back to you.
Force inversely proportional to the distance. Next, we have electromagnetism. Thanks to it, your phone works. Also, thanks to it, the universe can exist. Grimes, how electric and magnetic fields...
And you don't fall through the earth thanks to it as well, and pretty much everything else. Like, it's responsible for way more things than people even realize.
Are in fact the same thing, work. Briefly, it can be summarized as electrons and photons doing weird stuff. Then we have thermodynamics, which tries to explain why you shouldn't jump in lava. It also says that entropy tends to get higher, which will result in an inevitable death of the entire universe, called the heat.
If things keep playing out like they seem like they're playing out. No guarantees.
Death. We also have fluid dynamics, an excruciatingly hard way of determining how aerodynamic a cow can be.
I always loved that meme.
Chaos theory tries to describe how your life would have been if you hadn't said that really stupid thing to your crush back then. We also have optics, which pretty much studies how light behaves when it passes through glass.
Anybody out there? We're gonna get copyrighted for that.
The next big pillar of physics is relativity, relatively speaking. There is this dude, one stone, who comes and says that light speed is constant. And then people asked, well, what if I run faster than that? And one stone said, you can't because you're fat. I'm not fat, you reeky ill-breeding maggot. Your mass is not zero, so you are.
There's some truth to that one.
Bitch. Also, Newton, Your physics is shit. Gravity is not a force, it is the curvature of space-time itself. Next we have...
That was well done.
Quantum mechanics. A weird field with zombie cats, infinite versions of you, and the core of Rick and Morty. The standard...
I approve.
...model says that there are at least 13 types of particles. First we have fermions, 6 types of quarks and 6 types of leptons. Then we have 4 types of gauge bosons, and 1 scalar boson. Gluons obviously make glue. Photons...
That was really good. That was fantastic.
Gluons make photon cannon.
But you know, it's actually not too far off. Gluons do tend to hold some other things together. We're pretty sort of on the nose with naming things. So, you know, there's that.
Electrons make electricity. The muon is basically electrons' overweight unstable sister. The tau is basically the electrons' super-ultra overweight sister. It is also really suicidal and doesn't like to live for a long time. These guys like to pass through everything.
Very rare, those ones. You only find them because we make them, right? So those things are very strange and mysterious.
Through everything, without interfering with anything. These guys are just boring. These guys make up 6 flavors of Chupa Chups. They also make up protons and neutrons. The Higgs boson just makes you fat.
This is a fantastic video. Thank you for suggesting it. This is unreal. They should show kids this in physics class. Like when you first come into physics, first day, first 5 minutes before you show them that stat mech book intro, show them this video. I think kids would love this, and anyone really. It's just great.
Per string theory, which replaces all the elementary particles with really small vibrating strings. Different particles, different vibrations. It also argues that there are 11 spatial dimensions.
It doesn't replace them. I didn't catch everything you said. It doesn't replace them. It just says those things are emergent from the more fundamental things, much smaller, those strings. So it's not, you know what I mean? If string theory is true, the standard model is also true.
It also argues that there are 11 spatial dimensions instead of 3.
That's the M theory as well, that argues about the 11. Again, everyone loves talking about string theory because it's fun, it's crazy, but there's really no evidence for it, so be very careful.
It looks something like this. Good luck imagining that. Next,
I understand these are jokes, but I also just wanted to give people some insight. And so the actual, maybe you could say the consensus in the string theorist community, they seem to think that these dimensions actually are probably, you know, wrapped up and they're very small. And that's why, you know, where the hell are they?
Good luck imagining that. Next, I highly suggest to first watch this video on quantum mechanics.
Why do you get angry though? Because it actually is really cool and super beautiful. Like, and elegant mathematically. And that's why so many people love it. Like, it does seem too good to be true. And look, it might just be true. It might be ahead of its time. Like, we've discovered it too early, and the experimentalists haven't caught up yet. And it might be another 200 years before we can actually do experiments to verify it. So, you know, don't be too sure it's all BS. It's just might be well ahead of its time, like many other things. This has happened a lot in mathematics, for instance.
Otherwise, you won't understand much. Too lazy to watch it? Good luck. First, we have the Heisenberg's uncertainty principle, which states that he is the one who knocks. Oh. No, never mind. It states that you cannot physically know both the position and the momentum of a quantum particle at the same time. Then we have the Schrödinger's cat, which is both alive and dead at the same time until observed. This works for all particles, which exist in all possible states as long as it doesn't interact with anything else. Oh, also, when observed, the cat splits the universe in two, one with each.
So I know this is a jokey video, so I can just do this because why not? So he's talking about an interpretation of something that happens in quantum mechanics, and they're known as the interpretations of quantum mechanics or quantum theory. And one of those interpretations is the many worlds interpretation. And this has to do with the collapse of the wave function. It has to do with when you take measurement / observation of where an electron is around an atom, because before you do it, we think it's in this like probability cloud. This is superposition of all possible states, quantum states, in its orbital at any given time. And then you make a measurement and you collapse that probability cloud. It's aka wave function, which is not something that is related to anything in physical reality. We think it might actually be. Why? Because there's complex numbers in it. How can an imaginary number relate to something real? But from that, you can actually get something, a real, you know, a number, which is very confusing. So you only calculate probabilities in quantum theory, by the way. So many worlds suggest when, spin is a better example, because, you know, spin can also be in multiple states. For instance, everyone likes to say spin up or spin down, whatever the hell that means. These things do have this angular momentum. They're not literally spinning, though. And so you can, we just like to give these things arbitrary things sometimes, but then you can derive them later. And so we say spin up or spin down, or the combination of the two. And so when you try and measure it, though, it'll be one or the other. But many worlds says, instead of just collapsing, you know, the superposition and the possible states, it basically, the whole universe branches, and both things happen. So I don't think there's any evidence for that. And I think it's kind of pretty intense to invoke all of that, you know, out of something we don't understand. And it seems like there's a few assumptions. There are some people like, what's his name, who really likes this idea, and he's saying there's lots of actual incredible physics behind it. Not that I've come across any, but he's much smarter than I am. So, you know, maybe you should go listen to Sean Carroll over there. He's incredibly intelligent. He's a professor at Caltech, holds Feynman's old position, right? So this guy's extremely intelligent. He might be correct. I have no idea. He's very, very confident about many worlds. So you should know that. So it could be correct. Go watch his lectures. He's amazing. And then also, so that's many worlds. There's lots of other interpretations, lots. And most, the consensus is one called Copenhagen, which is pretty much, it just collapses, right? You know, and everything I've told you is like, that's just how it happens.
Continue. Version of the outcome. So a single atom can split the universe in countless ways, therefore creating a metric crap ton of parallel universes, according to the many worlds interpretation.
I guess it means, you know, infinite multiverse, right?
How seriously?
And if it's real, it kind of means like there's other yous out there, right? Not just other yous, there's an infinite other number of other yous out there. So there's exact copies of you out there, infinite exact copies of you out there. It's insane. All right. Everything that's allowable by the laws of physics, if this stuff is, you know, if there's any merit to it. Yeah, it's crazy shit.
Go watch this video to understand what I just said. I think I forgot to mention antimatter, dark matter, black holes matter, quantum gravity, the Big Bang, the infinite universe that is somehow still expanding, the Pythagorean theorem. It's because
why Pythagoras in there? So there's lots. This is clearly a joke video, right? Because if I was going to give you all of physics, you would describe what a physics degree does and break. You'd give you the big major branches that we've kind of given a name, even though all of physics is completely tied in together. If you're going to learn physics, get used to it. You got to learn all of it, which is not all in this video because it's all completely related. If you want to know it, if you want to go do some, solid state stuff or go work with quantum computers, you better know everything there is to know in, you know, quantum theory. You know, everything, obviously, but like have a good working understanding of how the thing is related to what you're doing. You'll just be much better off in those areas if you do, though, know most of it. And then, you know, you might think you don't need, you know, the larger things like general relativity, but then you should know, you know, we don't actually know yet how, you know, general relativity relates to quantum field theories and fields. We think gravity should have a quantum aspect. It should be quantum in nature because the universe seems to be quantum in nature. So, you know, that's why you should probably also know some of that, because there is the chance in the future we have a better, you know, version of gravity. And yeah, crazy shit, man, all round. I think we're almost finished.
Because I only have 5 minutes, not several human lifetimes that are required to understand how the universe works.
Safe to say no one understands how it works, and not even close. And so don't let any confident fool, you know, convince you that they know what's going on, because no one does. We're all as lost as each other. We're all a bunch of hairless primates walking around on this floating blue dot.
But this is totally enough to understand most of the physics memes.
That's true. That's the only important part. These look like some good memes. I guess for that video we just watched, that would be a good little bit. And now we can move off to something else.